that are a thing now too. When you're a blogger, your brand and your logo and your website does represent yourself, but you also have to be conscious about how yourself is being presented to the world. But if it's a service or a business entity or you're a chef, that branding has nothing to do with you and what you like, what your favorite color is, how you like to dress in blue all the time. It doesn't matter. Because if your audience and who you're looking to market to is not attracted to millennial pink and glitter, they will not occupy your business. They'll be like, that's not the brand for me. They'll turn it down and they'll move on. So it's important for me when I have my clients to talk about who their target audience is. I know that that's so cliche, but who that person is and think about their characteristics, because that's the first thing that I like to talk about is 10 adjectives to describe your customer. Are they spunky? Are they a mom? Are they conscious? Are they vegan? What do they do in the morning? Do they listen to Travis Scott or they more of a Luther fan? Like, these are important things to where you can curate a logo and a website that makes sense, because actually did Jill's website too, but if you know that person, you'll know how to design your website in a way that they won't waste their time and your jump rate won't be obscene. Because if everything that they need to know is not on the first scroll, they're not going to click and try to find any information. Most of it is millennials, unfortunately. We are just not a patient group of people. We don't like to click for anything. We want to just click, buy, cart, thank you, 3 to 5 business days. But it's important for me to communicate that to everyone, because it is a lot, just like Joseph, there's a lot of graphic designers, and I'm not like any other one. I'm very class, I'm very assertive, and I'm very direct, because I don't want to waste your time and have you invest what could be $1,000 into a brand that won't get you paid. I like to get people paid, because when you get paid, you become a return customer, they're happy. There are more black businesses in downtown Detroit that's becoming less of black owned, but that's another conversation. So I like to be class and upfront with you. If there's an idea that you have about your brand, I'm not going to say, okay, let's do it. I'm going to say that's not going to work. I'm going to tell you why it won't work. So with me specializing in color and design, I have made the ability to create my own color palettes and things like that, just so it's a little different. You might find that there's an orange or a blue brand that you just, I hear it all the time, like, her brand, she sells hair and it's pink and glitter. So I feel like I should do pink and glitter. And I'm just like, what if you were green and gray and you also sell hair? But because you're green and gray, you stand out from everybody else that's pink and glitter, and they take a little bit more time with you. I don't care if it's 5 seconds. If they take 5 seconds and they realize that you do this, they'll remember you over everybody else that might be pink and glitter. So, just like Ricky said earlier, first thing you do when you become a business is, I need a logo. But most of the time, I need a logo doesn't mean I want to invest $250 plus in a logo. So the second point that I wanted to say, I'm so long-winded, stop me if I need to stop, is you need to invest in a logo that costs you more money, because when you become an established business, I've been in business 3 years and I've changed my logo 5 times. And I just trademarked my logo, which is a $400 investment. And if you make a $400 investment to the government, they don't give it back to you because it didn't work. They take your $400 and they say, you can't trademark this because of copyright infringement, et cetera, et cetera. So when you invest in a logo, you want to make sure that, number one, all of the designs that person may use, they didn't go to Google and they didn't take a PNG and they copied and pasted it into your logo, because that Google image is probably copyrighted. And when you submit it to the Fed and you give them $400, they're going to say, I'm sorry, try next time. So I also want to put you in a position where you don't waste money, because $400 is half of my rent and I can't afford to spend $400. So it's important to research and make sure that everything that looks pretty is probably not good for you. It might look pretty, but make sure that you use search engines. You can use Google Images and make sure that the person on Fiverr didn't just upload something that came from Google and change the color and say, here you go, thank you for my $65. It takes more to invest in your business. And lastly, I also want you to understand that it's not going to be, your logo and your brand design is probably not going to be anything that you ever thought that it would be. It's not going to be anything that you ever thought that it would look like at first. But you'll start to understand during the process of discussing who your target market is, discussing, because I try to make people feel so comfortable that you to be comfortable with being uncomfortable, especially when it comes to your business, because it has nothing to do with you. It has everything to do with their consumer. So it actually might turn out that your favorite color is green, and it just might align with your target audience, because you might be. I've had people say, I am my target audience. Okay, sis. So it happens like that sometimes. But the last point that I want to say is it's a growing pain. We have the idea in your head, like, I want to do this logo that's cursifying, and I want all these different elements, and I want the face to work into a giraffe, to merge into a star, and spell my name at the bottom. It sometimes, and I love that creative energy because I'm an artist, so I'm like, we're going to make it happen, like, by any means, but it's just a growing pain. And just like Jill said, knowing who your brand, your target audience is, knowing when they're online, knowing how to catch their eye and how to keep their eye, because like I said, when you keep their eye, they spend money. When they spend money, you make points, everybody's happy. That's how economics works. That's how